to be here. I just talk a little bit in English. Sorry, my Spanish. I speak French a little bit, but this band is our first, el primero, ¿no es cierto? The band is called Andalucía Day. I have a group in New York called Canada Day. And so for this tour, we thought we would try some of the music from Canada Day with these wonderful musicians who I just met them all yesterday. We're having a very nice time. And so Canada Day is a band in New York. We have maybe been around for 5 years. And so the songs that we play tonight come from all of our older, from different records. So we've got them together and we'll play them for you. The first song, the name of the first song is 217. There's a school in New York where I used to teach that all the schools for the children have numbers. So the school was called PS, is public school, PS 217. So the song is called 217.
¿Qué tal? ¿Lo habéis entendido todo? Sí. Bueno, él, como más o menos, os resumo un poco. Aunque es canadiense, tiene un grupo en Nueva York que se llama Canadian Days. Entonces él, durante unos 5 o 6 años, ha estado con este grupo y tiene 2 o 3 discos y han grabado mucha música con ese tipo de formación. Entonces él, ahora que está un poquito de gira, pues nos ha montado un grupo para tocar su música, una música muy personal, que es la que vamos a tocar, y vamos a tocar un poquito varios temas de todos los discos que él ha hecho. Y nada, el primer tema es un tema que se titula 217, el número 17, que es como le llaman a algunas escuelas, al colegio público, que les ponen números, y este se llama pues a los 17.
Thank you.
next song is from our Canada Day's first record. It's called Keep Casting Rods. And I should have said, keep casting a line. It's about fishing. And I used the wrong words, even in English. But I just kept it that way anyways. But it seems like a nice title for Cádiz because, and for Puerto Real, because there's so much great seafood. Yeah. So I just want to go fishing. Anyways, keep casting rods. next piece is called Slow and Steady. It's from Canada Day's newest record. It took us a very long time to get it together, and we're working on it here also. Slow and Steady.
Vamos a tocar un tema muy bonito titulado Slow and Steady, que tranquilo, lento, y que nos lleva a unirnos a toda la banda para tocarlo.
Also from the most recent Canada Day record, it's called Settle, which means like, you know, relaxed. But It's not only relaxed, but for some reason that's the name. Settle. I don't know what the word is.
Quiere decir tranquilito.
But you decide.
Sentadito tranquilito.
Thank you.
next one is from our Canada Day's very first record, named after a city in Canada that I've visited many times. My brother went to school there. I got to know it very well and many musicians there. So I like it. It's called Halifax, which is on the very east coast of Canada, on the ocean, in the North Atlantic. And it's wind and rain and trees that are knocked down by ice, you know. So it's a very, it's beautiful, but kind of nothing happens at the same time. So that's what this song is named. It's called Halifax.
Bueno, ¿habéis entendido un poco?
Sí.
Sí, ¿no?
Nice.
No, es un sitio en Canadá donde realmente tiene la particularidad de que al parecer es un sitio que es muy bonito, pero que tampoco hay nada, que igual hace mucho viento, llueve, los árboles se caen, pero no acaban de caer. Es un sitio bonito, pero que en realidad tampoco pasa nada allí.
This features Javier Delgado on the bass. Thank you. Gracias. Next piece is from Canada Day's second record. Most of the music I wrote right after my son was born, so I was very sentimental, like sappy, you know, like.
Esto lo escribió cuando su primer niño nació. Estaba muy sentimental.
But so this is my son's name is Owen. This is called Song for Owen.
Se titula Canción para Owen.
Thank you.
please let me introduce everybody in the group, though. On the vibraphone, Arturo Serra. Teachers in the Gambia in West Africa for some trips to study traditional drums, and one of my teachers passed a few years ago, or actually only 1 year ago actually, but he was a wonderful drummer, beautiful guy, and he played a drum. The Mandinka people in Gambia play drums that are called Kutiro drums. There are three of them, a lead drum and then two supporting drums, and he played the kind of main support drum. Very skinny guy, but played like 10 men, you know. So his name is Mamadi Danfa, and this song is called King of the Kutiriba.
Bueno, como habéis podido entender, que sé que lo sé, pero para el que no lo sepa, él ha tenido un profesor, estuvo estudiando en África con uno de un profesor, no recuerdo ahora el nombre como ha dicho, pero él tenía un profesor y este murió hace un año. Él pasó varios tiempos estudiando con él. Era uno que tocaba de los tres instrumentos, el más pequeño, pero que tenía una fuerza y una energía para tocarlo que era increíble. El tema se llama King of the Kutiriba y es homenaje a su profesor.
Thank you.
much for coming. Muchas gracias. It's been a real pleasure. Thank you for listening to. Again, I'll introduce everybody's name together and we can maybe clap. Arturo Sierra, Pedro Cotejosa, Poro Garcia, Javier Delgado, Harris Eisenstadt. Thank you very much for listening. We have one more song. It's called Cobble Hill, which is a neighborhood in Brooklyn where I live. But please, for these much again for having us. Beautiful theater. The sound is great. We have no microphones. Amazing. Thank you to the presenters for having us. Thank you for coming. This last song is from an octet record, 8 instruments, yeah? A version of Canada Day that we recorded a couple years ago, plus 3 more instruments. But so this is an arrangement for quintet. It's called The Ombudsman, Part 4. It's part of a suite. And an ombudsman in English is somebody who works for the people or for the employees of a company, communicating with the government or the manager and trying to make sure that everything is fair for the people who work for the company or for the people from their government. So it says The Ombudsman, Part 4. That needs translation.
Es más o menos una persona que igual trabaja para el gobierno que va por su cuenta.
¿Lo habéis entendido? Sí. Porque yo creo que es una cosa muy importante, ¿no? Que es como una persona que trabaja, pero más de cara al público, ¿no? A la gente, ¿no? Entonces es como busca la justicia, ¿no? De cara a lo que al pueblo le interesa, ¿no? Entonces es como el mediador de cara al gobierno, pero siempre desde el punto de vista del pueblo, ¿no?
Thank you.